Hi everyone, it's Jessica here, and welcome to this Power Director workshop on double exposure. If you're looking to add a cool effect to your editorial toolbox, you might want to give double exposure a try. Usually, this is an effect that we associate with photography, but you can definitely do the same thing with video. So today, we'll be creating three different double exposure effects to make our own music video. Let's get started. For this first video, we'll be using masking to increase the versatility of our double exposure effect. First, let's import our video clip on the first overlay track. Next, we want to adjust the saturation, brightness, and contrast. Tap the edit icon, then choose adjustment. First, lower the saturation to zero to take away all the color. Then decrease brightness and increase contrast to give our black and white video more detail. Next, put the second video clip on the second overlay track. Let's resize and reposition this to make the clouds fit within the jar. Tap the edit icon, then choose adjustment again. Increase temperature towards the blue as we want a cooler color tone. Go ahead and tap blending and choose the hard light blending mode. Then tap mask and choose ellipse as we want to keep the clouds here within the jar. Use the slider to increase feathering. Now let's import our third clip on the third overlay track. Use the same techniques as the second clip and play around with the adjustment tools. As color grading is very subjective, you can try out different styles to see which you like the best. Now let's replay the entire clip, and as you can see, there are some masks that aren't aligned within the jar. Let's fine-tune the masks and use the mask keyframe to fix these. Move the playhead to the beginning of the clip and add a keyframe. Then move the playhead to the end of the clip and adjust the mask size. Once we're finished with our edits, let's produce and continue on with our second double exposure clip. First, import the clip to overlay track 1, then tap edit and tap on fade. Choose fade out as we want to make the illusion of the woman vanishing into the butterflies. Import our second clip to overlay track 2 and resize it to fill the preview window. Tap edit and choose blending, and choose the multiply blending mode. With multiply, we can produce different levels of darkening depending on the luminosity values of the blend layer. Here we're using multiply to reveal the woman's face within the butterflies. Next, tap on fade again and choose fade out. Then let's duplicate the video clip and drag it to the next overlay track. Let's trim to keep only the ends of the clip. For the duplicated clip, blending again. This time, let's choose the screen blending mode to make the black disappear to pop out all the butterflies. Then tap fade and fade in to create a crossfade effect among different layers to resync these two clips. Let's produce this entire clip and move on to the third double exposure effect. First, let's import the clip to the first overlay track and choose effect. We'll pick the glitch pack and let's use the aberration effect. Next, import the second clip to overlay track 2. Let's use another blending mode and this time we'll be using hard light. As we want to keep the woman's face, we'll have to use another mask. Tap on mask and choose ellipse, but this time let's invert the mask to show the face. Then tap on effect. Glitch again, and this time we'll use disturbance. For the third clip, import it to the third overlay track. Use the adjustment tools again to adjust the clip to your liking. Once finished, tap blending and we'll pick overlay. Overlay a black color board to create a vignette. Tap the overlay icon and add a black color board. Resize the color board to fill the preview window. Then tap mask and again ellipse to increase feathering with the slider. Lastly, lower the opacity. Now that we're done with the third double exposure effect, let's produce the video. And last but not least, open a new project and we'll put the three double exposure videos we just created together and add some transitions and music, and here's our final result. So in this tutorial, we demonstrated three different videos all with double exposure effects. Now it's time to try it for yourself. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and turn on the bell icon to see more video editing tutorials and updates. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.